Hello, I Love Lucy friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is KJ Ricardo, and today's episode is a look at the references from season 4 of I Love Lucy. Just like I've done with the first 3 seasons, I am going to show you references that are mentioned on the show. These references are from the 50s and even before then, and maybe you don't know what these references are really all about. And so the next time when you watch these episodes, you'll know exactly what everyone is talking about. So sit back and enjoy.
Mrs. Ricardo.
Oh, my goodness. I never noticed what beautiful blue eyes you have. Did anyone ever tell you look like Clark Gable?
No.
Oh.
Where's she getting the money?
Well, maybe your business manager got soft-hearted.
Are you kidding? Mr. Hickox? He makes you look like Diamond Jim Brady. What if she is playing the stock market?
Well, then we all better get ready for another crash.
Who are you trapping this time, Daniel Boone? Sam Carter, that fellow Dorothy Cook's been going with for such a... Did you call the club?
Yes, he left 2 hours ago.
Well, suppose we wait a couple of weeks and notify Ellery Queen.
But you know what they say, behind every great man, there's a great woman.
Is that what they say?
Yes. Empress Josephine, Dolly Madison, Mamie Eisenhower, we're all back there. We're puppeteers behind the scenes pulling the strings.
Well, here's howdy doody now.
Well, it's a husband and wife show or nothing.
Well, if you just give me a chance to explain.
Taylor, find out if Cougar is available.
Yeah, we.
Phipps Department Store presents Breakfast with Ricky and Lucy.
This is your big chance. Are you going to Muffet?
You can call me Little Miss Muffet.
Looks just as pretty off the screen as she does on.
Our studio is making a picture about the life of Don Juan.
Don Juan? Oh, Ricky, that'd be just perfect for you. Spanish and everything.
You have to develop a distinctive way of talking, like Humphrey Bogart.
Oh, yeah, I see what you mean. Yes, it is I, a lovely one.
Oh. What do you think you're doing?
Who are you supposed to be?
Gorgeous George.
Then when Daddy takes us out to Hollywood, we're gonna be a big star, too, just like Jackie Coogan, huh, honey?
Hi, Bing. Oh, Luella, darling. Oh, Hedda, I adore that hat.
Pardon me.
Alan Ladd lives right here.
Alan Ladd.
Being considered for top female roles around him are Marilyn Monroe, Ava Gardner, Jane Russell, Yvonne DiCarlo, Lana Turner, Arlene Gall, Betty Grable.
Ethel, that girl could be a second John Bunny. There, Ethel won't use these tickets.
Oh, that's too bad.
Did you ever see anybody as stubborn as that old mule of mine? Well, what are you going to do about our two mules sitting next to each other? Put blinkers on them? I'll go and tell, Francis, I bought the ticket.
You can't leave now. We have to tell him.
I can't tell him. He looks just like Buddy Rogers.
Tell Bill Holden that Marion Van Black saw Sabrina 5 times. Well, he'll be delighted.
You? You just learned this morning.
Listen, I drove for a whole hour. Oh, pardon me, Barney Oldfield.
Come on. But now that Mickey is a star, he can take my book right to Dory Sherry.
As long as we're here, we're in no condition to continue. We'll stay right here.
Oh. Here?
In Lower Slobovia?
There's Cary Grant. Wait. Picture on the end down there, is that a picture of Shelley Winters or Judy Holliday?
Peter, that's Eve Arden.
Thanks. Eve Arden.
One day on location, it rained, and on the way back, I rusted shut.
And when they got back, they called me and said, come down to wardrobe. We're opening a canned ham.
Bill, what's the last picture you made?
Well, we just finished shooting The Country Girl with Bing Crosby and Grace Kelly.
Oh, gee.
Guess who's down by the pool?
Who?
Robert Taylor.
No kidding.
Yes, sir. Maybe.
Oh, a lot of people get discovered. Why, there was Champ Butler. He was discovered parking cars. And then there was Dorothy L'Amour. She was discovered running an elevator.
Oh, well, it really is none of your thing.
Well, she thinks she's playing Camille.
Hey, dear, bye.
I got a date with Mr. Manelli, so I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Bye. Oh, Ricky. I would dearly love to have just one dress from an exclusive salon like Don Loper's. Not only that, but do you know who that is?
No, who?
Gordon McRae's wife.
Well, it turns out that Mrs. Dean Martin's been in.
Mrs. Dean Martin.
Mrs. Forrest Tucker. Mrs. Van Heflin. Mrs. William Holden, Mrs. Richard Carlson, everybody but Mrs. Joel McRae.
Favorites. Have you seen Raymond Navarro or Francis X. Bushman? Oh, and I must see the house where Rudolph Valentino lived. Oh, I'll never forget him in the sheet.
Oh, pardon me, I thought you were Burt Lancaster. Say, you know, you're just great for the lead in Esther Williams' new picture.
Maybe they'll put you in another one.
Oh, sure, yeah. Maybe they're going to use me in one of the Marx Brothers pictures. You know, Chico, Harpo, Groucho, and Floppo. Maybe I could borrow a couple of hundred Bobby Soxes from Frank Sinatra. Ricardo.
Yeah.
As in Montalban, yeah. Fernando. Yes. As in Llamas, yes.
Invitations went out last week to such notables as Esther Williams and Ben Gage, Elizabeth Taylor and Michael Wilding, Robert Taylor and Ursula Theus.
For heaven's sake, all those movie stars coming to my party? Let me see. Van and Evie Johnson, Carrie and Betsy Grant, June Allison and Dick Powell. Oh, mother.
I guess Lassie couldn't make it.
Listen to this item in Sheila Graham's column. A well-known...
Ricardo, if anybody finds out the Cornell Wild is here, the...
Will you really arrange so I can see him?
Sure. Tonight we'll go see his new picture, The Big Combo. Got wonderful reviews.
Oh!
President Eisenhower was playing golf with little orphan Annie.
Look up something good now, Lucy.
Rock Hudson.
In what? Rock Hudson has returned from a personal appearance tour with his exciting new picture, Captain Lightfoot, and he's resting.
A little. For 25 years, I felt like I was married to the good humor man.
We got it. Now, who else did you tell her that you've been palling around with?
Well, let's see, Gary Cooper. And, oh, yes, I did mention Marlon Brando. Marlon Brando. Did you see On the Waterfront? Wonderful. He got the Academy Award, you know. Well, that's a shame. Gee, that means that you didn't see Clark Gable or Walter Pidgeon or Hedy Lamarr. They were all down by the pool. And Ronnie and Benito. No, Ronnie and Benito were here last week. They probably won't drop in again this week. Oh. But, Ricky, you're having lunch with Richard Widmark at Romanoff's.
Correct.
He's having lunch with Richard Widmark at Romanoff's, and he won't take me along. Let me at the dirty rat.
Hey, now, never mind, Rocky.
Never mind.
Clark Gable's house is on the left, and so is Bob Hope's.
Is Mr. Alan Ladd's home.
Alan Ladd? Yeah, gee, it would be nice if we could see Sue Carroll walking around there.
And over here on the left is Shirley Temple's old home. Yeah. Right there by... And up the street there, that old English house, ladies and gentlemen, that is the home of Miss Joan Crawford.
Joan?
That ranch-type home on the left, ladies and gentlemen, belongs to Betty Grable and Harry James.
Oh.
Well, I was hoping to get some shooting in last summer in Germany. I made a picture there called Prize of Gold, but I was too busy.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to record a special thank you message because this week is celebrating my 2-year anniversary of having my YouTube channel, and I also reached 400 subscribers. That's amazing to me. Thank you so much for your love and support every week. Thank you for watching my videos and just appreciating I Love Lucy, The Dick Van Dyke Show, and my old Hollywood tributes, my movie reviews. Just thank you for appreciating the old Hollywood fandom that I am so happy to be a part of. Thank you for watching, and if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit the bell notification so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with another video, and remember to always laugh often.